Hello, welcome to my channel. I hope you're all feeling strong and well. Now it's a windy one today, and in this vlog we're going to talk about the Lumix G9 and my vlogging settings for this camera after owning it for 6 months. Now, we all know that the perfect vlogging camera doesn't actually exist. Will it ever be created? We don't know. My fingers are crossed. But I thought I would just let you know how far I've come with the G9 with my vlogging. 6 months I've owned this camera, and I thought it might be just handy for people that do own the G9 or are thinking of purchasing the G9 for a vlogging camera. Maybe I can shed some light on the settings that I use, and that might help you with yours. Save you a bit of time, maybe save you 6 months. Now, before I purchased this camera, I did do a lot of research. I could see people using it on YouTube as a vlogging camera, photography camera, and a professional video camera as well. It really is a good all-round camera, and it's recently had a firmware upgrade, and that really turned it into a more video-centric camera. So that made me interested in it, and yeah, so I did my research because it's not a cheap camera. So when I first got the camera, I unboxed it, put it on auto, and started vlogging with it, thinking that it would be perfect, but it was far from perfect. And I really did think in the first 2 weeks, I thought I've made a big mistake thinking that this camera could be a vlogging camera. But after 6 months of tweaking the settings of the Lumix G9, I think I'm ready to share my vlogging settings with you, and hopefully help you if you are thinking of purchasing or own the G9 and are struggling with your vlogging settings, because this camera can be used, as you can see, for vlogging. Now, do bear in mind that these settings that I'm going to share with you are tailored to my particular style of vlogging. So you might want to just tweak them yourself. And that's exactly what I did from all the other YouTube videos that I've watched on this subject. So I thank you all for your videos, fellow YouTubers, on your videos and settings on the G9. It was really helpful for me. So I thought I would put mine together and maybe help out some other people along the way. So just before we get into my personal settings for vlogging on the Lumix G9, let me just say that if you're thinking of purchasing the G9 for vlogging, or have already purchased the G9 and are wanting to vlog with it, you already know that you are sacrificing the size and weight of this camera, because it's a pretty medium size and medium weight camera. It's by no means a lightweight camera. You already know that you are sacrificing that for better quality video and better quality audio, and a far more flexible camera. This G9 is a brilliant photographic camera and a brilliant video camera. So basically, if you are serious about your footage and your audio for your channel, then the G9 might be a good option. So let's get into these settings. So first of all, I always record in 1080p. I've got no reason for 4K yet. 1080 looks good to me. And it's always at 24 frames per second, unless I'm of course doing slow-mo, where sometimes I go up to about 240 or have it in 60 frames per second. Now for audio, I've got quite a few microphones, and the one that I seem to be using most regular is the Rode Wireless Go, and we're using that today. Brilliant microphone, brilliant battery life, and you've got the flexibility of not having the cord, of course. So I have the Rode Wireless Go set to medium. There's three settings on there: low, medium, and high gain on the actual microphone. And I have it set to medium. And the settings within the actual camera, the external mic settings, are -6 dB. I've got the wind cut off because I find that quite intrusive. It does, it sort of does what it wants, got a bit of a mind of its own. So I rely on the actual wind muff of the microphone. So the wind cut is off, and I do have the mic limiter on. I don't find that too intrusive. I think sometimes it does save you from clipping. The picture profile is set to natural, and the white balance is set to sunny, because most of my vlogs are outdoors. So that is an outdoor setting, of course, and that seems to work well for me. Even if it's overcast, I find the sunny setting works okay. So what are my ISO settings? I've got the ISO settings to a minimum of 100 and a maximum of 1600. I find that works well for me. Now, face tracking and eye detect are on. But make sure you turn off on the Lumix G9. It's got an amazing thing called Animal Detect and Bird Detect. That's part of the upgrade package of the firmware. But make sure you turn the Animal Detect off, because I have found that it looks in the background and thinks it sees things. It thinks it sees faces in the background, as I do sometimes. But yeah, in the trees and stuff in the background, it can get it wrong sometimes, and it can choose to focus on the background instead of yourself. Now, the Lumix G9 and a lot of the higher end Lumix cameras have a feature buried in the menu of the automatic exposure and automatic focus lock. You'll find it in there. There's a feature called focus priority, and what that means is that you can set the camera to prioritize focusing on things close up, such as myself in this shot, and it will ignore focusing, trying to hunt for things behind me. And of course you can set it the other way around to prioritize for focus far away. So no prizes for guessing which one you set it for vlogging, which would be the near focus. And I've got that setting on near focus, so that should avoid it hunting in the background for other things. So for instance, if you've got the Animal Detect on and just the standard focus setting, then it can be looking in the background just because it decides to, and because it thinks it can see some animals in the background, or of course some faces in the background. So it's cutting down on what the camera thinks it can do, so you're taking a little bit more control of this fantastic camera. Now that brings us to stabilization. How do I have the stabilization set for my ultimate vlogging settings for the G9? Well, I've got the IBIS on, the in-body stabilization, and I also have the electronic stabilization on as well, and that does add a slight crop. So how do I manage to get such wide angle shots with the electronic stabilization on and the IBIS? Well, it's a good question that you ask, and the solution is unfortunately very expensive. I use the 8-18mm lens, the Panasonic 8-18mm lens. Expensive lens, it's coming in at £1,000. I managed to get it second hand, pristine condition. I was very happy with it. I managed to get it for £500, so really happy. And I thought I would make the investment in my channel, and because it's an outdoor channel, I did want to show you my world. So I thought I would invest in the wide angle lens, and I haven't regretted it. So we were talking about autofocus earlier on in this vlog, and the Lumix G9 has fantastic face detect, animal detect, eye detect, and bird detect. But once you've controlled that system and got it perfect for vlogging, some of it needs switching on and off, as I've told you previously. Once you've got that sorted out, then you are really taking hold of this camera and turning it into a perfect vlogging machine. But I just want to say that do yourself a favor when finding your settings for vlogging. Don't have a shallow depth of field. The shallow depth of field is going to cause the camera to get it ridiculously wrong sometimes, as they do. The autofocus is not perfect. No camera has the perfect autofocus. And when it gets it wrong with a shallow depth of field, it's going to get it miserably wrong. But if you've got your lens stopped down to such as f4, f8 in a lot of cases for me on a nice bright day, then pretty much everything is already in focus. So when it gets it wrong, it only gets it slightly wrong, and it's hardly detectable. So very important, don't try and work with a shallow depth of field unless you feel you've got full control of your camera and the shot that you're taking. Don't work with a shallow depth of field. Narrow down the aperture to something like f4. And beyond it, you can get to f8, and that is brilliant. I find a lot of my shots are at f8. Now, I say that, this shot is at 2.8, which is the lowest that this lens goes. So, funny that I should do that on this take. And of course, the reason that I did that shot at 2.8 was to prove my point. So I'm stood in exactly the same place, the same shot, and we're talking about the same subject, and we've got the camera set to f8. So it's f-stop 8, everything else is the same. So you should be able to see that the camera is no longer hunting. So if you have to skip back and just check out the footage, and you can just see it hunting a little bit. It doesn't do a bad job actually, but it can get it a lot worse than that with a shallow depth of field. So that first take was with the lens, the 8-18 millimeter at 2.8, which is the widest aperture, the shallowest depth of field. We are now, as I say, at f8. Everything is in focus. It's a nice bright day, and I'm sure the camera has done a far better job. I don't have to fear that the camera is going to lose focus, because everything is in focus. And with the near focus enabled and the animal detect turned off, we now have the perfect settings for the G9. So they are my vlogging settings for the Lumix G9. I hope you've enjoyed the walk. I've enjoyed your company as always. Or of course, I would have been all by myself. Now, these settings that I've shared with you, because of the fantastic custom settings menu of the G9, and you've got a custom setting dial on top with three different settings. In fact, in one of them, there's three sub settings. So lots of custom settings that you could have on this camera. And I have saved these settings to custom number one, to C1 on the top of the camera. So if I make adjustments on the fly when I'm out and I sort of lose my way, I can never lose my way really, because all I have to do is switch back to C1 and I'm back to my favorite custom settings, specifically designed for my style of vlogging. Of course, you could tweak these settings yourself, but I hope this has helped at least one person who has got the G9 and is struggling to use it for vlogging, or if you're thinking about purchasing the G9 for vlogging. It certainly can be used for vlogging. It's a fantastic all-round camera, amazing camera. So yeah, I hope you've enjoyed the vlog. If you have enjoyed the vlog, give me a thumbs up, give me a like, and consider subscribing. I upload a vlog every week. I don't know where I'll be next, but I know I want you with me. So if I don't see you through the week, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.